things I've been hearing: accountability, consistency, and execution are the key. It's one thing to have knowledge. It's one thing to read. It's one thing to go be motivated. Yeah. It's totally different, though, to integrate it and to live it and to be it. And so since we have really what time we do have, I'll just put it that way, I want to just go through some distinctions that maybe could be a guidepost for you and move you in a direction, kind of like a roadmap for that. And also, since my love, my passion is the Silver Method, some of these distinctions with why it stands out, why it's the most copied, most imitated program, that just about every thought leader who's out there got their start in Silver. Some were even beginning instructors in that way. So more importantly, she has up on her board, taking charge of your life from the inside out. I think we all would agree that when it comes to managing our lives, when it comes to really being in command of our lives, it's not an intellectual pursuit, is it? You could have 22 PhDs, with due respect, it serves a purpose, but it's really about what's going on inside us. Agreed? Can you relate? And that's what I... So for me personally, as an instructor, and I encourage other instructors, I very much resonate with that aspect. The other thing too is our mission is sort of to navigate life with more grace and ease. And Heidi, a couple of things, you promoted me. I'm not on the board of directors of Silver International. I'm just an influencer. I'm an advisor. I'm the most consistent instructor. I'm there just about from the very beginning with that. So it's a family-owned business. So if they watch the recording, they want me to acknowledge that, just advising. So more importantly, though, about you, so many of you work with people, your coaches, or you're working in healing. And I mean, that can be so demanding. And today, I think anytime, and today perhaps more than ever, flexibility in our thinking, flexibility in our actions is so necessary. Would you agree? And the ability to pivot and to turn. And unfortunately, or unfortunately, just the way it is, with technology moving, like for example, my industry, this craft, to me, this is a mission. I really do not relate to the young people coming into this industry and a lot of the big, big names, where there's such an emphasis about scaling up and about money and about, you know, the multi-million dollar platforms. That's cool, don't get me wrong. But what really got me involved in Silver was the sense of a mission to help humanity to evolve so that we can truly take command of our lives. That's why Jose Silva originally called it mind control, Silver mind control, self-control, not being like a sheep following the other sheep to the slaughter, being able to, and one thing I'm really loving here is your authenticity and the informality of that, you know, the realness, if you will, with that. So I want to offer you as part of that roadmap, and we'll see what we can interject, four pillars, four necessary skills that regardless of what your work is, whether you're a massage therapist, a Silver instructor, a business person, a stay-at-home dad or mom, in any scale today, we all have concerns, and not just during a pandemic, with respect. So there are four pillars, and these pillars are the very pillars that the Silver Method is built on. Mr. Silver spent 1944 to 1966 researching everything from hypnosis to meditation to wisdom teaching to brain studies. Back then it was biofeedback. So it's a long story, but just know that there's a lot of that. Life and Intuition System is the new updated format of what we used to call the basic lecture series. So I say that because there's a lot of information, there's a lot of freebies, there's a lot of great, wonderful introductions out there. And that's about what they are. Even Mind Valley, it's an introduction. It's not the coursework. It's a pre-recorded video with no instructor. So the way Jose intended this is live like this, even virtually. So when I do classes, it's me there with people. And when we do our mentoring sessions, that. So let's look at these four pillars. Number one, I don't know if it's fair to say it's the most important, but without it, nothing else will work. So number one, it's important that each of us are able to leverage our energy. So what does that mean? Is life is what it is. Even the most fortunate of men and women, no matter how much you make an effort, no matter how much accountability you have, we have mishaps, agreed? Sometimes we don't miss the mark. Things happen, life happens. That's what Bill, he didn't go into detail, and it's not appropriate now, but he hit a lot of things during COVID, stuff that happened that directly affected his business. It's just the way life is. So it's important that we stay in a state of being that's abundant, if you will, a state of being that's feeling appreciative and generous, a state of being that is feeling gratitude rather than lack and worry. So if we go into fear mode, so if we get overwhelmed with stress hormones in the body, the brain will take over and we go into fear mode, and that's a scarcity consciousness that's lacking. And if you've ever heard the expression, desperate people will do desperate things. So even I've seen it too often, even the most beautiful, well-intended people, if they don't have a handle on their day-to-day living, on their energy, and they're not able to somehow, some way, however you do it, stay calm and focused, even under duress, even under pressure, even under crisis. It doesn't mean that we're not concerned. It just means that if we freak out and we wallow in it and we worry, we go into stress mode. And when that happens, number one priority for the brain is survival, and we lose it. So what that does is it causes us to be able to change our brain state to be centered, to be balanced. And when we can balance our brain chemistry, when we can balance our body chemistry and stay in homeostasis, we think more clearly. We're more likely to be focused. Agreed? Have you noticed? I mean, real simple. I mean, I'm talking to the choir here, I think, here today, is that if you're feeling worried and stressed, and we all go through it, I used to be CEO of the club, Warriors Anonymous, you're more likely to make a mistake. Agreed?
Yes.
Amateur mistake. I can't believe it. Like amateur. You're more likely to slip your mind about something. You're more likely to have an accident, and you're more likely to get sick. Because when the body gets overwhelmed with stress, it weakens the immune system. So one of the pillars of the Silver Method is meditation. It's the difference that makes the difference. It's not an intellectual or academic approach. It's not about reading books. Here's a little plug. Fantastic book to read. And there's a lot of home studies, but the key is bringing it to life. And that's what we do in a live training. We're practicing, we're integrating it, we're taking the material. So when you're in that state, and you can, and by the way, I don't do it every morning, an hour. It depends, 15, 30 minutes, frankly, it's usually about 30 minutes. And I've just found that when you own your morning, you've got to own your morning. I don't go near my phone. I don't turn on my phone sometimes till 10:30 in the morning. I stop looking at emails at night because what am I going to do? I stop looking at social media because then it gets, and you guys know this, right? So we've got to do things to keep balanced and centered. And when we do, that would lead to the second pillar. We think more clearly and we know what we want. Have you ever had difficulty knowing what you really want? Hands up high. I mean, please, I don't want to be alone, you know, because we have conflicting intentions sometimes, or sometimes we being asked to do something. Even us silver instructors are independent contractors. We're all, you know, work on our respective territory. I'm different because I'm a training director, and there are only four people in the world doing advanced trainings. Jose, God bless the guy, saw that in me and brought me in to do that. So my career is a little bit different than the average instructor. But if we're in a state of dread, or if we're out of integrity and we don't realize it, it means our goals, what we think we want, is not in alignment with our values on what's important to us, who's important to us. And when we're out of alignment, we get demotivated easily and it's hard to sustain momentum. Would you agree? I mean, come on, guys, help me out here. Have you not noticed that? I mean, because I don't know about you. This is my 50-year career. I turned 70 this year. And people say, wow, but do I still have days where I don't feel like doing anything? Yes. I'm very good at goof-off days, Heidi, you'll be happy to hear. Spontaneous, I said, Barbara, can you take off? Because she does some work 3 days a week. And we went up to Maine for 3 days. I don't know, we had maybe 2 days' notice. I'm not taking care of our grandchildren. We've been on alert. My son, things worked out. We got the call. And 2 days later, 4th of July, I flew out to California to bring home my two grandchildren so that they could take care of what they need to take care of there. Plus, they're visiting us. So when we're in alignment with our goals and our values and what's really important, it's easy to find the energy, isn't it? It's easy to find the resources, and you think more clearly. You're more likely to have ideas. So a second pillar is we need to be clear about what we want, what we truly want, and make sure that our wants are consistent with our values in alignment. Because if they're not, it's too easy to drift. Agreed? And it's too easy to be easily influenced. Throughout my career, I've been recruited more than a few times to work with other people. And because I'm so in alignment, my values with this mission that Mr. Silva started for us, that I stay focused on it. The third pillar, when we're managing our energy and we're able to maintain a level of calm and focus, even under stress, and we know what we want, we're in alignment, and we're focused. Then we need to have some confidence in ourselves that somehow, some way, we can figure it out. Agreed? So notice I didn't say change your limiting beliefs. Everybody and their mothers talks about changing limiting beliefs, and it's true. We do have limiting beliefs. I agree. It's almost like it's become a buzzword. And what that really means is that we don't have all the answers. But if we have the confidence that I don't know how, but somehow, some way, I'll figure this out, then we stay in alignment, we stay focused, we stay calm. And when we're calm, we're more likely to have intuitive insights, we're more likely to experience synchronicities, we're more likely to attract the people that can help us get what we need to get. And that's why all throughout the Silva class, we're practicing. So I just got an email that I read earlier to clarify. It's one thing to read a book. It's one thing to watch a video. I have lots of videos out there on my YouTube channel. But it's another thing to have what's called deliberate practice. And if you do the studies on peak performance, now there's a lot, the name is shifting to high performance. Deliberate practice very simply means you get immediate feedback. You have a task, something to do, and you do it, and you get immediate feedback while you're in that state, while you're in the zone, so to speak. And it's easy then to make corrections. It's easy then to make an imprint and to make the necessary shifts. And that's a big distinction because all throughout the class, people are get mentoring, guiding, and modeling, watching people interacting. Not just me, Silva instructors, excuse me, for that. That's part of and what Heidi is doing in her mentoring process, giving immediate feedback. So we're practicing with the tools and techniques of self-improvement, whether it be your co-creation skills, whether it be sleeping better at night, whether it being able to get rid of headaches without drugs, managing pain without drugs. It's very common for people to go through the class, and because of all the meditations, by the time we finish 4 full days, they're not always pain-free, but substantially reduced, sometimes pain-free, but definitely a big improvement with that. So that confidence comes from, Heidi said before, one step at a time. Brilliant, right? Simple brilliance. Because when you get feedback that says, okay, I made some progress, only a little bit, that gives us a little bit of confidence. And then when we have that confidence, it gives us courage to do a little more. And then we do a little more and we get feedback that says, yes. And that gives us a little bit more confidence. And we say, okay, this is getting fun. And we do a little more. And by the way, I don't mind telling you this, I'm very old school and I'm proud to be old school. And even the virtuals, I do them virtual. I had to pivot during COVID. People were begging me for the classes and I had to do, and all of them fill up and they sell out. It was like, oh, okay, I guess. But if you don't have somebody to ask questions to, you don't have that deliberate practice. You don't get to make those corrections. But I got to tell you, like doing videos, doing Zoom sessions, which Zoom does make it easier, I don't mind. I was a little bit like Karen was there, the very first one, and Karen knows me from Chicago, and she was coaching me saying, "Ken, you're on the money, Ken. I've been with you live, Ken. You're hitting your marks. Thank you, Karen." Because I told them up front, I said, "I don't know how this is going to go. You know, it's over, you know, the computer. I'm used to feeling your vibe, you know, the energy in the room." So I got that deliberate practice, right? And each one has gotten significantly better. So it's really important what Heidi, her message before, about step at a time. So when you've got your energy managed and you're not allowing yourself to, by the way, it's very dangerous. If you're getting overwhelmed with stress hormones, it's going to lead to overwhelm. And then you feel helpless and hopeless. And if you feel helpless and hopeless, it's the precursor to depression. And that could become very serious. And I'll stop there with that. So when the brain takes over or those stress hormones take over, all I can say is good luck. Then you might need the meds. Might. I hope not, but you might. And then you're clear about what you want. You're in alignment. You're focused. You've got even baby steps. You have some confidence that gives you the courage to do something new. Then you'll experience the synchronicities. So one of the big distinctions is our program, the Silver Method, although you learn some wonderful, very practical tools for self-improvement, Mr. Silver's mission was to help awaken the subjective faculties of the human mind, to help people recognize we all are psychic. We all have intuitive abilities and it can be trained. And I can tell you, we were sharply criticized even by very well-known psychics, but today it's common knowledge. I think most everybody agrees it can be trained. So our whole program, we spend about 50% on average or more practicing. And then day three and four, we spend 60% of our time practicing with intuition, where you get immediate feedback. And we help you to develop, okay, what's the difference that makes the difference when you're correct, when you're not? So what I'm saying, guys, gals, is that whether you do silver, whatever is your approach, it's important that you have some points of reference that when you are using your intuition, that you have feedback. And you journal it, or you pay attention and study it, so you begin to recognize, man, I was off on that one. Clearly, wishful thinking. Boy, I was on the money, baby. You know, give yourself a high five. If you do that often enough, eventually you begin to recognize patterns, and you begin to recognize in how you think and how you feel, you know, with respect to that. And it's a lifelong process. And Heidi, you were very generous again with my intro. I didn't teach my mother. My mother saw the change in me and took the silver class. And then she wanted to practice. So I gave her a tape, back those cassettes, of Jose Silva himself. I said, "The man, my mentor." And she said, "Nah, I don't want to listen to him." My mom was 4'11", very cuddly. I was born very late in her life. They're long gone. And so I made the long relax, the big relax. Jose spent 22 years perfecting this. Dynamic meditation means you can be passive and active at the same time and not lose it, contrary to what the Maharishi used to suggest was impossible. Now they agree. I'm so blessed to be a pioneer with the man who kind of was such a forward thinker. So she listened every day to this 28, 30-minute exercise. Every single day, she did the work. You got to do the work. And when you do the work, whatever it is, that's when you get results. And it's the cons you show up, right? You do the consistent application, execution of whatever the work is for you. It's not always meditation, but whatever it is, and you get results. Some people sure get results faster. And that's okay. But as long as you're making progress, what I would close with is, you want to finish your day saying thank you, God, thank you, Source, thank you. It's funny, Carlo, mentioned about his rosaries. When my mom and I was talking to them, I went to an intro lecture and I told them I was interested in this mind control stuff and it could help me. My mother took out her rosary beads and started praying for me, and she turned white as a ghost. I was raised in a very dogmatic Roman Catholic background, so can imagine. But then when she saw the changes, she opened up. So, four pillars: relax, be able to manage your energy, be able to stay calm and focused, even under pressure. Know what it is you want. Make sure what you want is in alignment with your values, who or what's important to you. I mentioned my grandkids, give a little plug for them. They give me these gifts. They're number one. My family is number one. So I dropped everything, and I have two big programs coming up, but I'm not working nearly as much because I agreed to watch them and be with them and enjoy their company. And then third, do anything you can to build your confidence, to have the courage to do something more, to step out of your comfort zone, which will allow the intuition to thrive, and make sure you figure out, are you wishfully thinking? Are you in fear? Or is there truly inner wisdom guiding you? I think a little bit more. Are we good?
I think
Forgive
so,
us.
Ken. Thank you so much. Does anybody have any questions if you want to stay after? You can leave because technically 4 o'clock is supposed to be the end. But if anybody has any questions, Ken, what's the best way people can reach you? Can you put your information in the chat so if people have questions outside of this, they can reach out to you?
Yeah, sure.
Or if they're interested in learning more about your life and intuition system.
I have several emails. Some is just for family. So here, I want to demonstrate to you how old school I am. And then you can laugh and make fun of me. I still have a bloody AOL account.
I think my favorite was when you were teaching the course, you're like, I'm just going to use my easel. And you brought out the easel and you're writing everything like we were in person. I loved it. It definitely gave it a little bit more like in-person feel as opposed to here's another Zoom meeting. So
Yeah, and I don't do screen shares anymore because I found it disruptive in the process. So I printed my PowerPoint. I don't use all of them, but anything that's key that I want them to write down and show it, so I can still be there talking and watching people. Because part of what the process is, I would say transformation takes a lot of work and effort. So one of the benefits of having someone like Heidi mentor you is that when you're on the screen like this, you can, you're watching your group and you're seeing how they're responding or not responding. And therefore, we're very gental and I'm very gentle. I hope I'm not scaring you, but I do watch. And I might turn and say, hey, Dan, how's it going, Dan? And interesting, sometimes Dan, I don't think Dan is shy, but if he were shy, then he would speak up and he'd ask a question that he wouldn't before. And that can make a big difference because if those little questions are not answered, people give up. And that's one of the things Mr. Old School is concerned about with all the freebies. It's confusing. All the, home studies out there, people skip around. They don't even finish. They go from disc one to disc 10. And it's a step by step. And when you got someone guiding you and they have a mastery of that process, it makes a world of difference, with that.
so does
But I put
anybody
my
have a
phone number.
question for Ken?
And I do answer my phone. People always say, God, you answer your own phone?
Marika.
I just wanted to ask you, Ken. I've been wanting to do it actually, because you mentioned the meditation, the original meditation from Silva, José Silva. Do you still have that? Is it possible to buy it?
Yeah, you have it. I gave it to you. The long relax. That's her, oh, you mean with his voice?
Yeah.
Actually, I don't. I saved a lot. I admit, not thinking ahead about saving, when cassettes became obsolete, there are things I didn't save, and there's this fabulous presentation. So if I can get it, I will for you. I haven't really, because some of the early ones, the quality was not good, and his accent was way too thick, and people had trouble understanding. So it depends when it was done or when not done
I
with him.
found one on YouTube.
I
Really?
have the old ones,
And
but the
don't you?
tapes, I have the old cassette tapes. But what I found is they won't turn. You put them in a tape player, and the tapes are so old that the tapes themselves don't
Right. So it's
function
not going to
properly.
help Marika. It's not going to help Marika here. So, what can I do? Other
Thanks.
questions?
Thanks. Does anybody else have a question? I don't see any other hands. So I
Okay.
want to thank all of you for staying a little extra And thank you, Ken, for sharing those four pillars with us.
Can I say one last thing?
Yes.
I would say whether you're interested or not, if you are at least been interested, this is the best book out there. And it's better than any home study program because it's step by step. It's slow. It's slow, very slow. But if you follow the instructions, this was written in the early 70s. And to this day, people come into the class because of this book because they got such wonderful results. And to this day, people talk about it, you know, when like in chat roles on various things. And it's also got a lot of research in the back, studies, you know, medical studies, psychological studies, to back up what we were saying in EEG studies. But even if you just do that, I always recommend this book to people. Thank you.